My name's Molly James. I'm a PhD researcher at the University of Plymouth, and my research looks into improving our understanding of how marine larvae behave. Most marine species have this larval development stage. So organisms like crabs, lobsters, mussels, oysters, even fish have this stage. During this period, they're really, really, really tiny, and they're not very good at swimming. So their transport is reliant on the currents of the ocean. Where larvae travel during this developmental period is really important to understanding how ecosystems function and how the populations in the marine environment are connected. What we tend to do is use a computer simulation called a biophysical model. And what this does is we take our knowledge of the ocean currents and we couple it with predictions of larval behaviour. However, our understanding of how larvae behave is limited, and this can make our model estimations inaccurate. We think that larvae use behavioural responses to environmental cues and oceanic features, such as light and tides, to govern when they swim up and down in the water column. And this is really important because depth differences can cause them to be exposed to different current speeds. For example, if a larvae were to be nearer the surface where the currents are faster when the tide was coming in, and then swim down and be nearer the bed where the currents are slower when the tide was going out, its net movement would be towards the coast. And this would be really beneficial if it was a species who as an adult likes to live on the rocky shore. The trouble with this approach is that we tend to observe how larvae behave in a laboratory and apply these behaviours as rules in our biophysical models. But we don't really understand how larvae behave in the sea rather than in the lab. And because of this, we often don't do well at matching patterns of vertical distribution to those that we see in nature. And this can lead to model error. Our research has stepped away from the laboratory, and we've developed an approach that allows us to work out how fast the larvae must swim and in what direction they have to go in order to match the profiles that we see out in the sea. Over a tidal cycle, larvae make much more complex movements than would be predicted by these lab-based rules. So what our research does is provides a toolbox for scientists to use to work out how larvae are behaving in situ. This can be applied to any species that has a larval development stage.